Hello, my name is Sheridan Spotek, and I'm with Nebraska Extension in Lancaster County. Today, we will go through the steps of incubator setup. It is important to allow 21 days or 3 weeks for your chickens to hatch. 2 weeks prior to receiving your eggs, plug in your incubator to make sure it's running properly and that the temperature is correct. Unplug your incubator and plug it back in 24 hours before the delivery of your eggs to help build up temperature and humidity by filling up the troughs with water, as shown later in this video. Before they hatch, you need to make sure you have an incubator, an egg tray, and a thermometer. We will place the egg tray on top of the incubator mesh and the thermometer on the egg tray. Another important part is to keep in mind is cleanliness. You want to make sure your kids wash their hands before and after handling the eggs. Eggs have pores in their shell, and it's important that kids wash their hands before handling so that chicks don't receive germs that the kids may be carrying on their hands. The eggs also come in a natural state, so they have not been washed or sanitized like eggs may be in the grocery store. So you want to make sure your kids' hands are clean after handling the eggs as well. For the proper development of your chicks, you want to make sure you have the correct temperature. Temperature is extremely important. The ideal range is from 100 to 102 degrees Fahrenheit. If your chicks are set at 99 degrees Fahrenheit, that is okay, but they will have slower development. If your temperature is at 103 degrees or above, this will cause the chicks not to hatch. It is important to know that the digital screen on some incubators is not an accurate representation of the temperature inside the incubator. In some cases, the screen may say 103 degrees, but the actual temperature is 100 degrees on the inside. You can adjust the temperature by pressing and holding the up and down arrows. It is important to know that because we don't reference the screen, you want to make sure you place the thermometer close to the eggs so that you get the most accurate representation of what the internal temperature is inside the incubator. Humidity is an important part of the development of your chicks. Your school may be provided with one of either of these trays. This tray has 5 compartments, and this one only has 2. Depending on which trough tray that you have, you may fill them up differently. Please keep in mind that we use food coloring in our water, so your water may not look this blue. In this tray, we filled up the first trough and the middle compartment. In this tray, we filled up just the middle compartment. It's important when you're filling up your troughs with water to use lukewarm water. You don't want it to be too cold or too hot, as that will fluctuate the temperature inside the incubator. It's important when filling up the troughs that you do not go over the brim and fill them completely full. During days 1 through 18, you want to make sure that these troughs don't go empty. Churning is important for the eggs as it provides exercise for the developing chicks. Think about you or your students. You don't like to sit in a chair all day long. It's nice to get up and move around. Chicks are the same way. We provide them churning so that they can move around inside the egg and get some exercise. It is important to churn the eggs 3 times a day, once in the morning when students arrive, during lunch, and before they go home. On the weekends, you can churn them once a day, but 3 times would be ideal. When you receive your eggs, they will all be marked with an X. It is important to place your eggs on their side and level in the egg tray. You do not want to place them up and down, but rather on their side and level. When your students turn the eggs, if the X is on the top, turn it so the X is on the bottom, keeping the egg level when you're done. When they turn them again, if the X is on the bottom, turn them so the X is on the top. You want to make sure you do this an odd number of times a day instead of even, as it provides an equal distribution of exercise for the chicks. On days 18 through 21, your chicks are getting ready to hatch. In preparation for hatching, first take off the lid. You will remove the tray and fill up the rest of the troughs. Turn your eggs one more time and place them on the mesh. You will also want to keep the thermometer inside the incubator. Place the lid back on and leave it on, and your chicks are ready to hatch. When they start hatching, leave them inside the incubator, removing shells now and then. Chicks can survive 48 hours without food or water, as they are still utilizing the yolk that they had during development. Leave the chicks inside the incubator for 12 to 24 hours. Use your best judgment for when taking out the chicks. If they look strong and able, go ahead and remove them and put them in the brooder. They may look wet, but to the touch, they are actually just sticky. If your chicks seem lethargic and not ready to come out yet, simply leave them in the incubator for just a little bit longer. When your chicks are ready to come out of the incubator, they are ready to go in the brooder. Please see the separate video on the steps to set up your brooder. Remember that a little bit of tender, loving care can go a long ways in the success of hatching your chicks. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact the Nebraska Extension in Lancaster County for more information.